This is Andy. Andreas is an engineer, a jack of all trades. But most of all, he is an avid traveler. A few years ago, he bought himself a 32-year-old ex-military Land Rover Defender. With an adequate overland travel-capable vehicle now in his hands, an idea started to form in his head. Take some time off and go traveling with the Defender. For a while, it was nothing but a pipe dream. In the beginning, he was dreaming about driving through Africa. But after a while, it became clearer that he would find more landscapes that interested him in the Americas instead of Africa. But it was still a pipe dream. Then, one day in November 2022, his employer decided to restructure the company and told him that he was no longer needed. No longer constrained by a job, the pipe dream suddenly could become a reality. He shipped the truck to Halifax, Canada, and set off on an adventure. Now bear in mind that he has no experience in filming, video editing, color grading, or telling a compelling story. Please have patience until he is up to the task. These are his stories. Start. The ship was late and he had to wait over a week in Halifax until his car arrived. After a long wait, there's not really that much to do in Halifax. The ship finally arrived. Once he had his car, he made a quick stop at the Hopewell Rocks, the place with the highest tidal amplitudes in the world. An average tidal range is about 3 feet, but at Hopewell Rocks, sea level rise between 32 and 46 feet. The next day, he crossed the border into the United States of America to head west through the USA, and then north from there, back into Canada, towards Alaska, from where he would start his journey to the most southern point of the Americas, Patagonia. The idea is to not drive on highways or interstates, but use small backcountry routes to see the real America. So he set off on the Northeast Backcountry Discovery Route, a route created by a group of motorcyclists that had the same desires as Andy. Thank you. Unfortunately, it was very early in the season, and a lot of roads were still closed from the winter, which led to many detours, and he had to backtrack a lot. He got frustrated by the lack of progress and the constant backtracking.
And it's closed again.
Change of plans. I really like the idea of driving from east to west using just back roads and small trails and seeing the real America without using interstates and big highways. But if I look at the map, I'm not making any progress because it's really slow and all the closed roads, all the backtracking and detours, it's costing so much time. And the scenery is nice, like driving through the forest and these little towns and stuff, but it's not spectacular. Like all the real good stuff that I'm looking for, it's in the west. I've decided tomorrow I will abort, go on the interstate and drive west as fast as I can. Thinking maybe a week or whatever it takes, but getting west. When I get to New Mexico, I'm going to go back on the trails and the small roads. And then enough, I was spending the night at this little historic marker park thingy, whatever it is. And 2 a.m, I got woken up by the sheriff. He just wanted to see if everything is okay. And he's never seen a car like this with a pop-up roof and probably never seen a Defender before. And he just wanted to see if everything is okay. Checked my ID and was a really nice young guy and talked for quite a while. He'd like to go traveling as well, but he just had a small baby and blah, blah, blah. It was nice, but he woke me up at 2 a.m. and afterwards I couldn't really sleep anymore. So it was a bit of a short night.